once again, everybody. What's doing? What's happening? Yeah, I'm finally back. God bless. Oh, man. With allergies kicking my tail the last 4 or 5 days, and with all the turmoil over the channels and everything, please forgive my appearance, but that's just the way it is. I don't know what I got to say. I guess welcome to the new Swingman 1938 channel. Jesus Louise. Pardon me for that, but first of all, I'll try and make this video as short as possible. Maybe a little while, but I'll try and make it as short as possible. First of all, everybody who's watching right now, to everybody who resubscribed so far, thank you guys. I've tried to get the message out the best I could, like on my Facebook. And I put in my channel, I put in the search keywords, I put Swingman 1937. So then, and apparently it's apparently working. So so thank you guys, thank you for and also special shout out to W Farrar 69. Thanks guy, thanks for and Kenny Roxable, both you guys, thanks a lot guys for putting the word out there and letting everybody know, hey, I'm back as Swingman 1938. But as far as the channel goes, your YouTube channel goes, and the whole Google crap, just let me say this one little thing. Do not, I repeat, do not delete your Google account. Okay? If you delete your Google account, it'll take your channel right with you, and there's nothing YouTube can do about it. It's just gone, just like my channel was. A couple of weekends ago, no, excuse me, last weekend, I spent all weekend with the guys at the YouTube 1-1 support. Trying to get my channel back, and even trying to get my channel name back, at the very least. No help. They're no help on that. They said no, once you've deleted the Google account, that's it. That's it. The channel's gone. And you can't even get your name back. You can't even get the channel name back. Everybody, I can't say it enough. Do not delete your Google account for your YouTube. Otherwise, channels gone. And that's it. It's gone. So, anyway, I'm back. Well, I never left. It's just my damn channel left. And of course, the Kentonfest. The Kentonfest is still on, okay? And I've counted... I've had a lot of time to count up. I counted up the sides, folks. This Kentonfest, this Stan Kentonfest, is going to be wall to wall Stan Kenton and his orchestra. 64 sides, folks. 64 sides, including 2 albums. One is of course the Artistry and Rhythm album. The four records, 78 RPM set. And the 10-inch LP. I've got a 10-inch LP here of Stan Kenton, a presentation. The album's called A Presentation of Progressive Jazz by Stan Kenton and his orchestra. And it's on 10-inch LP. And that's 8 sides. And after that, I got 48 78 RPM sides after those albums. 48 78 RPM sides. It's going to be wall to wall Stan Kenton for a little while, folks. So kick back, get settled in. Bring a couple of lunches, man. You pitch a tent. It's going to be a big one. And I don't know what else to say. As far as the channel being gone, I'm sorry. I apologize to you. And it's going to be a long haul to rebuild 4 years worth of work. My apologies again for folks who have used my channel for education, reference, and just to listen to some good freaking music. I'm sorry, but I, like I said, I haven't gone anywhere. I'm still here, and I still got the records. Still got the records, and I'll be getting those back up as soon as I can. It's going to be a long process, but I'll do it. I'll be able to do it. So, and speaking of records, got a couple of new ones. No more 25-cent, thrift center fines. But it was via Facebook, kind of. There's one wonderful lady named Cheryl. She has a little antique shop, a little antique shop, and apparently a big warehouse. And anyway, she came on to one of the Facebook groups. What was it, about a little over a month ago, I think. And she said, "Hey, I got a bunch of 78s here. How much do you think I should sell them for?" And I got on there right quick, and said, "Well, it depends on the artist and the shape that they're in." And she proceeds to post what she's got, and I gave her ballparks and stuff, and lo and behold, that night, she took my advice, and lo and behold, that night, the whole thing sold. the whole thing. And she gave me a message back, says, "Mark, I can't thank you enough. If you ever get in town, I owe you a couple of drinks." And so I said, jokingly, I said, "Well, I appreciate that, but I'm a little bit far away to get a couple of drinks and make it back sober." So how about a couple of records? Just kind of a little humor there. And she goes, "You got it." Huh? So, yeah, she sent me a couple of records for helping her out. A couple of 78s, and I got them right here, as a matter of fact. Off camera here, but got a couple of them. And they're ones I've been looking for a long time. They're not really all that rare, but they are definitely groove juice worthy, I'm telling you. The first one of the two is Count Basie. One's called, the one side is "I Never Knew," and the flip side is the biggie, "Tickle Toe" by Count Basie on Columbia. And I don't know if you can see that there. Not matching sleeves, but that's okay, because this is a nice clean copy. Nice clean copy of "Tickle Toe" by Count Basie. I've never had that. Been looking for it on 78 for decades. Haven't seen it on the open market. And all of a sudden, boom, it shows up, and boom, she sends it to me, So it's, yeah. It's a decent copy. And this next one, excuse me. This next one, I donated. I had a copy of this, and I had donated it to a charity auction back in 2000. I think either 2000 or somewhere in the early 2000s. I donated to about three or four auctions in the early 2000s, charity auctions. Some of my 78s. This is Cab Calloway on Brunswick, on Brunswick. And this is, let's see, the first side is "Doing the Rumba," And the flip side is the biggie that I've wanted to get back. Trust me, I had no regrets in donating my records to charity. Okay, but I really wanted to get another copy of this. And this is on Brunswick, you know, Cab Calloway, Minnie the Moocher, guys. That's the original March 3rd, 1931 recording right there of Minnie the Moocher, the original. And, it's not really all that rare. It's probably one of the easiest Cab Calloway Brunswick label records that you can, that you could get. But still, it's great. It's just awesome to get it again. And I love it. That's a decent copy too. So anyway, that's about it, folks. Those records will be coming up sometime after the Kentonfest. I'm going to after this video, I'm going to start in on the Kentonfest. As a matter of fact, the first video, of course, will be Stan Kenton's theme, which is Artistry and Rhythm on the original Capitol number 159, first pressing, and we'll kick it off pretty soon. I've already got the video for Artistry and Rhythm, and I don't know. I may post it tonight. I may post it tomorrow, but either way, it'll be the first video right after this one. So, folks, that's about it. I really thank you and appreciate you. You follow me over to the new channel, and I appreciate you. Thank you for your patience. I love you all. I've said it dozens and dozens of times, and I'll say it once again. You guys are what keep me going. I'm serious. And if it wasn't for you guys, I probably wouldn't even, give YouTube a second thought, But I love you guys, And in the meantime, thanks for watching. Get ready for Kentonfest. It's going to start. Gonna start right after this video. So thanks again for watching, and until next time, just take good care.